Thanks, dear viewer, for joining me on this tour of Fannie Bay Gaol, or jail, in Darwin, Northern Territory, Australia. His Majesty's Gaol, a neighbor prison, was set up as a heritage site in 1979 and is free to visit. The site was formally opened in 1983. You can tell it's a prison. The fences mean business. The site was was opened in 1883 with 31 prisoners. Many of the prisoners were in fact Aboriginal. Many of the buildings have been reconstructed, and many were damaged in 1974 with Cyclone Tracy. The gallows are located in the old infirmary, and there have been only two executions, a 20-year-old Jerry Cool and 19-year-old John Nova Tree. This map shows the location of the Fannie Bay Gaol. Let's look at the beginnings, 1872 to 1883. The prison was moved from Palmerston to this more remote area of Fannie Bay, which had not yet been settled at that time. Now let's look at the first years, 1884 to 1911. The prison was located miles away from the rest of the European population in Palmerston. Didn't have much water or amenities, and it was surrounded by rainforest. Prison was controlled by the Commonwealth between 1911 and 1939. The Commonwealth takeover brought little improvement to the administration, although there were separate accommodation for the female prisoners for the first time. The prison was operated during the war years from 1939 to 1946, operated by the military. After the war, from 1946 to 1954, the jail was regarded as temporary, and there was little construction or maintenance. Prison numbers increased greatly between 1955 and 1974. In 1974, the prison was badly damaged by Cyclone Tracy, leading to its eventual closure in 1979. The prison was badly damaged in the Cyclone Tracy of 1974. Notice the infirmary lost its roof. The prison was closed for good in 1979, with a new prison constructed further outside Darwin. 1983 was taken over by the Northern Territory Museum Board, and they are operating it as a historic site. Let's move on. These are what the posters look like on the wall. Unfortunately, they're very badly faded by the sun. This building was for the children. Toilet facilities inside. Well, if they freed me from this prison, these photos are pretty well self-explanatory.
Bet I'd move it on a little farther down the line, far
for Aboriginal prisoners in particular, art became a very important media for communication. Some of the Aboriginal artists, in fact, became quite famous. I hear the train coming, it's rolling around the bend, and I ain't seen the sunshine. I don't know when I'm stuck in folds in prison. What do you think of the drawings? It's rather strange that the records kept by the prison are very patchy and incomplete. The quality of the writing certainly is good. Now we'll check out the kitchen. Prisoners got the chance to eat socially in a mess. I bet there's rich folks eating in a fancy dining car. The medium security wing contained mess cells with no privacy, so the prisoners could talk to each other. And this was really preferred by the prisoners because they could be social. The Aboriginals preferred this type of imprisonment, and research indicated that they were less likely to commit suicide. Now we'll take a look at the infirmary. It dates back to 1887. This board describes the brutal murder of a taxi driver and the pursuit of the two people believed was. The funeral was a big affair with a huge number of citizens turning out. Forensic evidence was gathered in the search for clues as to the murderer. A 20-year-old and 18-year-old youth were caught and sentenced to be hung. I hear the train coming, it's rolling around the bend, and I ain't seen the sunshine. Pictures of Darwin in the early 1950s. During the era of capital punishment, 11 men were hung in the Northern Territory. 8 were hung in the Fannie Bay Jail, but only 2 in the infirmary. The gallows were built in February 1952, and Malaysian pearl divers were hired to dig the graves. Here's a picture of the gallows used to hang. These are the gravestones of the two murderers built into the prison wall. After Cyclone Tracy in 1974 demolished the thought of the prison, the roofs were secured with extra rivets and screws and considerable support, as shown by these rods. Separate confinement was the worst possible imprisonment for the most severe criminals. A tiny little pen and two totally enclosed tiny little rooms. This is the muster area where all the prisoners were counted every day.